What did Jesus mean when he said, the lamp of the body is the eye? Let's talk about that text. In Matthew chapter 6, Jesus is giving us a prolonged discussion on righteousness. And he's approaching it by talking about some things that a righteous person is not going to do. Well, when we get to the section about money here in chapter 6, we see a perfect illustration of what a righteous person is going to do or not do. So Jesus says in verse 19, do not lay up your treasure upon the earth where moth and rust destroys and where thieves break in and steal, but lay up for yourselves your treasures in heaven where those things cannot happen. And then immediately following that, we have what many scholars and Bible students have considered to be some of the most confusing verses in all the New Testament. As a matter of fact, a number of commentators would say we're not exactly sure what Jesus is getting at in this section in verses 22 through 23. There he says, the light of the body is the eye, and if the eye is good, then the whole body is full of light. But if the eye is bad, then the whole body is full of darkness. And if the light that is in you is darkness, how great is the darkness? So what is he talking about? The eye of the body, it's good or it's bad. It's something that is light or it's darkness. What is he talking about? Here is a great exegetical principle that serves us so well in our study of the Bible. If in the previous verses Jesus was talking about money, which he was, because he's saying, lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven. So he's talking about what we're doing with our earthly money. But do you notice that when we finish the section about the light, the eye is the light of the body, Jesus says in verse 24, no one can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one or love the other. He will serve the one. Well, he ends that by saying no one is able to serve both God and mammon. Well, mammon is the word for money or for riches. So he's talking about money. So here's the principle. If we're talking about money in verses 19 through 21, and if we're talking about money in verse 24, then we're talking about money in verses 22 and 23. Now that helps us, because now he's talking about how do you look at money? Your eye looks at money either in a godly perspective, and if you see money from a godly perspective, then your eye is clear, your eye is good, and that's going to impact your whole body is going to be full of light. But if you look at money in a non-Christian way, an evil way, which is actually Jesus' word, then your whole body is going to be full of darkness, because now you're not seeing things like money in the way that money should be seen. And so by looking at context, the whole idea of context really helps us understand the meaning of some verses that some people consider to be very difficult.